Good morning, all of you. Open your books, page 43, chapter number 4. Okay, we will revise this concept check first. Then we will do the EV topic and then we will revise the chapter number 1. Clear? So be very attentive and open the book, page 43. First one, I'm going to write. I'm going to read and you will write the answers in the chat box. First is the arrangement of dash decides the states of matter. Very good. Hargun has written. It is the particles you can write. It is the molecules. Both are correct. Jasmine also has written. Inch, very good. The arrangement of particles or arrangement of molecules decides the state of matter. Ke matter solid hoga, liquid hoga, ja gaseous hoga. If particles are very close, to solid hoga. If particles are not very close, to liquid hoga. If particles are away from one another, distance is more, they are very loosely packed, then particle, uske bahut loosely packed hai, to the matter will be in gaseous state. Okay? Yes, you will keep your yes, Vanshika, beta, mute yourself. Second, condensation is the conversion of dash into dash on cooling. On cooling, what happens? Very good. Yes, Sargun again, very good answer. Who is doing this? You will mute yourself. And you will not share the screen. Gas will turn into liquid. Okay? Gas will turn into liquid on cooling. Why? Because, yes, Krishang.
Vedika, ma'am, Vedika is there.
Vedika. Ma'am, remove her.
Okay, ma'am, okay.
It's not one step process. Yes, condensation is the conversion of gas into liquid on cooling. What happens on cooling? On cooling, molecules come close to one another. That's why gas changes into liquid. Third is the particles of a substance come dash on cooling. Abhi maine bataya. No, beta, decrease nahi aayega. The particles of a substance come closer. Very good, Ashdeep. Yes, Jashan, good. Increase bhi nahi aayega, beta, close. In a particles in a substance come close on cooling. Speed decrease hoti hai, but wo yahan pe fit nahi aayega word. So we will write close on cooling or closer on cooling. Dono theek hai. Fourth is a dash liquid dissolves completely in water. Miscible, very good. जब हम liquid की बात करते हैं तो we use the term miscible. M-I-S-C-I-B-L-E. Very good. Jashan, all are, you are writing very quickly, but some of you are not writing. Be attentive so that you learn these things. Fifth is a dash is the substance to be dissolved in the solvent. Yes, solute. Very good, Ashdeep. Manminder. Yes, please.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Answer. Yes, beta.
Ma'am, fourth ka answer tha, ma'am. Network problem.
Fourth mein miscible. Miscible. M-I-S-C-I-B-L-E. Fifth mein solute. Jo bhi cheez hum solvent mein gholte hain, we call it solute. Like sugar is dissolved in water, so sugar is solute and water is solvent. Next is heating increases the dash of particles. Very good. Speed. You need to write it once. Okay. Das baar nahi likhna. Heating increases the speed of particles. Good. Now one box is there, green in color. Do you know what is in it? Okay. Listen carefully. Isme hai ki when we dissolve sugar in the water, it is reversible or irreversible? You will tell me. Write it in the chat box. When sugar solution is formed by dissolving sugar in water, it is reversible. It is not बेटा फिर से आप इनरिवर्सिबल लिखती हो, इट्स नॉट इनरिवर्सिबल, इट इज इरिवर्सिबल, आई डबल आर इन एन नहीं आता इसमें. इट इज नॉट इरिवर्सिबल, इट इज रिवर्सिबल बिकॉज व्हेन यू हीट द सॉल्यूशन वाटर विल गेट इवेपोरेटेड एंड sugar will remain in the container. You can get it back. जो पानी evaporate हो रहा है उसको आप cool करके collect भी कर सकते हो. Okay, so they can be separated. So we can reverse it. So this is reversible. Clear? So now one EVE topic is there that we need to do. For that I'm going to share the screen. By the time you will write the name of EVE topic which is NPT1. So PT1 में आपका टॉपिक है EVE टॉपिक. डू यू नो विच वन इज देयर? यू हैव सीन द सिलेबस? ओके यस, राइट द नेम. EVE टॉपिक कौन सा है? Animal word. Clear? Animal word is the EVE topic and this is very easy. You have done this in second standard, third standard also. Kuch bhi isme difficult nahi hai and all the time you get options or you have to write, you need to write one word answer. Aur jo cheeze aapne very easily choti classes mein ki hoti hai usi mein se hum. Then we don't
excuse me, ma'am.
Give any notes regarding this. Hanji beta.
Ma'am, ye paper 25 marks ka aayega ki 50 marks ka?
Beta, aapko instructions denge hum log. Most probably 25 marks ka. You can put these type of questions in the end, okay? 5 minutes before the meeting. Yes, beta, wait. Let me revise this topic first. Then I'll give chance you to unmute. Now everything we will told you everything before the exam. Now next one is EVE topic, animal word. Now write in the chat box a few names of the animals which you see around you. जो आप अपने आसपास animals देखते हो, write the names फटाफट से, quick. Yes, dog. Yes, cat. Dog, cat, bus. Parrot, yes. Frog, very good. Cow, good. Yes, we see a number of animals. Okay, bull, horse. आप सब बड़े बड़े animals के name लिख रहे हो. You see many small animals also. Okay, animals, maybe big animals, maybe small. Yes, insects are also animals. Lizard, cockroach. Now you are getting, yes, mouse, rat, lizard, ants. Yes, good. Okay, now next is we can categorize the animals into different groups on the basis of their habitat. Do you know what is habitat? What do you mean by habitat? Habitat is the living place of an animal. Animals, some animals they live on land, some they live under the ground, some of the animals they live in water. Okay, they live on different places. So on the basis of the place where they live, we can categorize the animals into different groups. Clear? So, first of all, we will take the example of animals which live in water. What do we call these animals? Now, don't write the name of animals. You have to see this. What do we call the animals which live in water? Fish kehte hain. Aquatic. Good, Vanshika, Girisha, good answer. We call aquatic. Yes, what helps the animals to live in water? How do they breathe? How do they move? What is used for the movement? Yes, fins. And what do they use to breathe? Gills, very good. Okay, so they use the gills to breathe and their body is spindle shaped, boat shaped, which help in the easy movement. Clear? Very good. Okay, then whale, whale ke bhi lungs hoti hai? No, इसके ब्लो होल्स होती हैं. दैट्स व्हाई इट कम्स अगेन एंड अगेन आउट ऑफ द वाटर टू ब्रीथ. गुड. ओके, यू शुड टेक इंटरेस्ट टू ऑब्जर्व द एनिमल्स. नाउ सम ऑफ द एनिमल्स दे लिव ऑन लैंड. व्हाट डू वी कॉल देम? एनिमल्स विच लिव ऑन लैंड आर कॉल्ड. अभी भी कुछ बच्चे डॉग कैट लिखे जा रहे हैं. Now write, what do we call the animals which live on land? Very good. Terrestrial animals. We call them terrestrial or land animals. Okay, terrestrial or land animals. Some students are now writing the correct spelling. Theek karo beta. Terrestrial or land animal. Clear? Next is, some animals, some land animals, we can further categorize them. Animals which live in desert, hot places where there is no rain or less rainfall, we call them desert animal. One is in front of you, we call it sheep of the desert. Write a few more animals which you can see in desert. Yes, desert animals की और examples कौन सी है? Write it. Camel तो है, is in front of you. Some other animals? Okay, scorpion, good. Cactus is not an animal, it is the plant. Clear? Scorpion, snakes, rattlesnake, snake is there. Okay, good. Now you can see the polar bear. Where does this animal live? Yes, crabs are also there. Polar bear, ice. Okay. Yes, it lives on the mountain peaks. Live in polar regions where there is very less temperature. It lives in very, it is mountainous. Okay. It lives in the mountain peaks. And some other animals also live over there, like penguins, okay? Sea lion, walrus, very good. Okay, now look at this. What do we call the animals which spend most of the time in air? Yes, Vanshika, aapka answer aa gaya, very good, beta. Inch. Yes, air animals nahi kehte, beta. They are called aerial. Okay, aerial animals which spend most of the time in air. Okay, aapke samne kuch birds hain and other birds or other animals, you can write in the chat box. Yes,
part. Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes,
beta. Excuse me, ma'am.
Ji.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Ji, beta.
मैम यहाँ पर जो है एनिमल लिव ऑन द लैंड. मैम तो एनिमल्स लैंड पे भी लिव करते हैं मैम, उनको कहते हैं एक्वेटिक. और मैम टेरेस्ट्रियल एनिमल वो कहाँ पे रहते हैं जो उन्हें कहे?
बेटा टेरेस्ट्रियल को ही हम लैंड एनिमल कहते हैं. क्लियर? टेरेस्ट्रियल को ही लैंड एनिमल कहते हैं. उनके दो तरह से हम उनका नेम ले सकते हैं, इधर टेरेस्ट्रियल एनिमल और लैंड एनिमल. क्लियर? तो ये एयर में रहते हैं, ये भी लैंड एनिमल की ही कैटेगराइज करते हैं हम इनको. तो दे लिव, दे स्पेंड मोस्ट ऑफ द टाइम इन एयर, वी कॉल देम एरियल. नाउ यू हैव टू राइट सम अदर एनिमल्स व्हिच लिव इन द एयर, दे स्पेंड मोस्ट ऑफ द टाइम इन एयर. एक्वेटिक लिव इन वाटर लाइक फिश.
एक्सक्यूज मी मैम.
ओके मैम.
Pigeons, like butterflies, like bats, they spend most of the time in all the birds. They use wings to fly. Okay, they fly here and there. Most of the time they live in air. That's why we call them aerial animals. Clear? Eagle is there. Some insects have wings. They live over there. Clear? And नेक्स्ट कैन यू नेम देम बेटा डोंट अनम्यूट कैन यू नेम दिस एनिमल यस कोआला वेरी गुड इट स्पैंस मोस्ट ऑफ द टाइम ऑन द ट्रीज There are many animals. They live on the trees. Most of the time, they spend on the trees. So we call them. What do we call them? Write it. Yes, arboreal. Very good, Vanshika. Yes, good. Pushpinder, Dharia, all are answering. But many of you are not answering. They are called arboreal animals. They spend most of the time on trees. Now write down a few more animals which spend most of the time on trees. One is in front of you, koala, and others, monkeys. Very good. Okay. Yes. Squirrel is there. Good answers. Yes. Okay. They spend most of the time on एक फ्लाइंग स्क्विरल होती है उसको हम एरियल में भी ले लेते हैं ओके चिंपैंजीज ग्रीन स्नेक्स ओके वो रहते हैं ट्रीज पे मोस्ट ऑफ द टाइम यस नेक्स्ट एम्फीबियंस एम्फीबियंस मींस व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय एम्फीबियंस यस एम्फीबियंस आर द एनिमल्स व्हिच Yes, amphibian ki definition you have to write. What do you mean by amphibians? Yes, yes, they live both on land as well as in water. Very good. Okay, these are the animals which can live on land as well as in water. Okay, ye maharaj kaafi kha pi kar kahan pe baithe hain on the land, but it can live in water also. Pani mein bhi ye reh sakta hai. Can you name which organ it uses for breathing in water? When frog is in water, which organ is used for breathing? Yes, moist skin. Under water, it uses moist skin. On land, it uses the lungs. Clear? Very good. On land it uses lungs and in water it uses a moist skin to breathe and it has webbed feet to swim in water on land it uses its legs okay so they are called amphibians yes some animals they live in the forest we call them wild animals jungly animals okay jungle mein rehte give a few examples Few animals are in front of you. They spend, they live in the forest. They are wild animals. Lion is there. Tiger is there. Okay. Yes. Some other animals. Bear is there. Yes. Wild beast is there. Deer is there. Monkeys are there. Okay. So these are the animals which live in the forest, and we call them wild animals. And now in front of you are the domestic animals. Domestic animals means we keep them at farmhouses. Okay, we use them. We keep them for our benefits. Some of them, okay, they guard the house like dogs. We keep them to guard our houses. Okay, ma'am has sent the link. You can fill the attendance sidewise also. Clear? These are the animals.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Donkey, cow, horse, buffalo. You know all these animals. Okay, now if we talk about the movements, so some animals, they move with the help of short legs. Like crocodile, alligators, they crawl on the land with the help of short legs. And some of them, they have wings also. They can fly, and they have all the insects. They have most of the insects have three pairs of legs. They run very fast with the help of these legs, like cockroach. Clear? And some insects have wings. They fly, like butterflies. Clear? Yes, ma'am, send the link once more. Some of the animals, they hop. Hop means they can jump. Like frog is there, it has strong hind limbs. Uski piche wali legs bahut strong hoti hain. It can hop. Clear? So, depending upon the mode of or type of food the animals eat, what type of animals, what type of food they eat, we can also categorize them. How can we categorize them on the basis of the feeding habits? Yes, feeding habits.
Excuse me,
ma'am. How can we divide them? But you don't unmute in between. Write the answer in the chat box. Yes. We can call them herbivores, carnivores, and omnivores. Okay? Herbivores means animals which eat only plants. Carnivores means they depend on the animals for food. And omnivores, they eat plant products as well as animal products. Okay?
Man, scavengers bhi hote hain.
Scavengers are the animals which eat dead animals. Okay? So, dead animals ko apna khana banate hain. So, this is very easy. This was all about the EV topic. Now, open your chapter number 1.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Ji, beta.
मैम जो डेजर्ट्स में एनिमल्स रहते हैं उसे क्या कहते हैं
डेजर्ट एनिमल्स ओके
मैम एक्सक्यूज मी मैम
जी बेटा
एक्सक्यूज मी मैम व्हाट इज द मेन डिफरेंस एलिगेटर एंड अ क्रोकोडाइल
एलिगेटर एंड क्रोकोडाइल ये स्पीसीज हैं एनिमल्स के नेम है क्लियर जैसे ह्यूमन बीइंग्स हैं फ्रॉग है
गुड मॉर्निंग मैम
ये एनिमल्स के नेम
Excuse me, ma'am.
Give it up.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes, now you Excuse have me, to ma'am. The questions related to chapter number 1. Open your chapter number 1. I'll send you a worksheet also.
Ma'am,
excuse me, ma'am.
Ma'am, animals that live in cold places?
Mountaineers, we call them.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Mountaineers.
Don't unmute like this. This is only the disturbance. Write in the chat box. I'm reading the chat sidewise.
Excuse me, ma'am. Ma'am.
जी.
Ma'am, जो वेस्ट्रम जो होते हैं, ma'am, whale, ma'am, वो ma'am बार-बार पानी के बाहर आती होती है, ma'am, पानी के ऊपर वो ma'am सांस लेने के लिए.
Yes, बेटा उसके lung gills नहीं होते, उसके lungs होते हैं. In order to take oxygen from the air, it comes again and again on the water.
Okay, surface. Thank you, ma'am.
Yes, now you will not unmute. Write in the chat box.
Excuse me, ma'am.
And open your chapter number 1. Write in the chat box if any query is there. आपको कुछ समझ नहीं लगा, आपने कुछ पूछना है तो write in the chat box. Otherwise, I'm going to put the questions related to chapter 1. Then I'll come to know ki aapko learn hua ya nahi hua. Okay? Kuch problem to nahi hai. Yes, first of all, yes, write it. Which part of the seed helps to give the food to the growing embryo? Yes, write it in the chat box. We have done the structure of the seed. How many parts of seed? 3 parts. Seed coat, cotyledon, and embryo. Which part of the seed it gives food to the growing embryo? Yes, most of our writing correct answer, cotyledons. Can you write another name of cotyledons? Can you write another name of cotyledons? Yes, cotyledons ka aur kya kehte hain? Seed leaves. Simran, very good. Yes, seed leaves. What do we call? Seed leaves. They provide food to the growing baby plant after germination. Then what do you mean by monocot plants? What do you mean by monocot plants? Give an example.
मोनोकोट प्लांट्स
मोनोकोट प्लांट्स और मोनोकोट सीड्स
मैम मोनोकोट प्लांट्स नहीं होते मैम जिनके पास वन सीड होते हैं
वन सीड नहीं होता बेटा वन सीड लीव होती है ओके सीड नहीं होता प्लांट्स व्हिच हैव द सीड्स व्हिच हैव ओनली वन कोटिलीडन वेरी गुड ब्रह्मज्योत ओके सीड्स विद वन कोटिलीडन आर कॉल्ड मोनोकोट्स बट आप एग्जांपल्स गलत दे रहे हो इट मींस आपने रिवाइज नहीं किया Many of you are writing Rajma. Rajma को आपने देखा कभी? Yes. अब ठीक examples आ रही हैं. Wheat, maize. ये सब है monocot plants. आपको मैंने अच्छे से examples दिखाकर पढ़ाया था ये सब. You have to be very attentive in the class and read the chapter carefully. Otherwise, you will not be able to answer.
मैं कम कर रही हूँ.
Yes. If one cotyledon is there, those Monocot, if two cotyledons are there, seed is called dicot. Dicot ki examples hain, bean seeds, rajma, ye sab kya hain? Dicots. Clear? Yes. Now, what do you mean by germination? Write it. What do you mean by germination? Yes. Germination is a process. Germination is the process by which, yes, it's not very correct, Japji, you have to describe well. The process by which seedling grow into plant. No. Wo to growth hogi. Seedling kya hoti hai? What do you mean by seedling? When a bean has a baby plant in it, the process of I'm not getting the correct answer. Near about आप बता रहे हो but it's not the very correct. Yes, by which a seed produces. Now Harshita has written correct answer. It is the process by which seed produces a baby plant. Okay, baby plant को हम कहते हैं seedling. When seed germinates, it means seed has grown seedling. Seedling को ही हम baby plant कहते हैं, okay? Now you are getting the good answer, correct answers. The process by which a seed grows into seedling is called germination. Done it? Now got it, beta? Yes, wait there for 2-3 minutes, then you can ask. Yes. When the seed germinates, After the germination, which part grows first? Write it. Which part grows first? Yes, which part grows first? Now I'm going to unmute. Yes. Parth, beta, unmute yourself.
Yes, ma'am.
Radical. Okay, which part grows first? Radical. Then after the radical? After the radical? फटाफट से बोलो. Which part grows after the growth of radical?
Shoot.
Plumule. What is this? Plumule. Or shoot, we can call it. Plumule. Plumule grows after the radical. Radical grows downwards. Later on, it will grow in the form of root and shoot or plumule. It will start growing the leaves. When leaves are grown, then plants start doing photosynthesis. Then cotyledons shrink. Before the plant starts photosynthesis, Okay, by that time, the food is provided by the cotyledons. Okay, beta. Now, what do you mean by seed dispersal? What is seed dispersal? Yes, write it. Rest of the students will write. Manraj will unmute to answer. Manraj, what is seed dispersal? Unmute yourself.
The process of getting away the seeds from the mother plant
Yes, आपकी आवाज नहीं आई बट क्लियरली बट इट वॉज करेक्ट आंसर.
एक्सक्यूज मी मैम, द प्रोसेस बाय process of secreting the seed from the mother plant is called the dispersal of seed.
Scattering बोलना है इसको, ठीक है? The process of scattering. Scattering means taking away from the mother plant. Mother plant वो plant जिसको seeds लगे हुए हैं, okay? We have to carry that those seeds away from the mother plant. That process is called seed dispersal. It means scattering the seeds away from the mother plant. Okay, what is? आपने जब लिखना होता है चैट बॉक्स में तो टू द पॉइंट आंसर शुड बी देयर बट बी क्विक टू राइट इट. प्रोसेस ऑफ स्कैटरिंग सीड्स अवे फ्रॉम द मदर प्लांट. Why is it necessary to scatter the seeds? Raghav, unmute.
मैं हैंड रेज.
राघव,
उन्होंने नंबर भेज दिया.
यस राघव, इट आर क्विकली अनम्यूट.
चार मिनट
लगे. वंशिका फसल.
मैम मैम, हम इसलिए मदर प्लांट को सीड से दूर करते हैं बिकॉज जो सी मदर प्लांट है वो सी जो बेबी प्लांट होता है वो मदर प्लांट से छोटा होता है, इसलिए जो मदर प्लांट है जो बेबी प्लांट को इनफ लाइट नहीं मिलती, स्पेस नहीं मिलती, वाटर नहीं मिलती, सनलाइट नहीं मिलता, एंड दैट्स व्हाई हम मदर प्लांट को बेबी प्लांट से दूर कर देते हैं.
आपका आंसर करेक्ट है बट आपने मदर प्लांट और बेबी प्लांट नहीं बोलना, आपने मदर प्लांट और सीड की बात करनी है, ठीक है? Seeds are taken. Seeds are taken away from the mother plant. If now mute yourself. If all the seeds they germinate under the mother plant, then they will not get proper amount of air, water, and sunlight. They will not get the proper space, so they will not grow well. They will not be healthy. Clear? वो healthy नहीं होंगे. There are different ways of scattering the seeds. Okay, some of the seeds are scattered by air. Okay,
ma'am.
So,
ma'am, I have.
हाँ जी बोलिए जिसका doubt है.